right, are you ready for a little meatball palooza? We certainly are. I want you to meet the co-owners of New York hotspot, the Meatball Shop. Daniel Holtzman is the executive chef and general manager. And you guys, I just hugged you, but I know you're Michael.
Sorry, I was hiking.
Don't worry. We're in love. We have a shared love of the meatball. I know you guys have been best friends since high school.
Long time.
And you used to eat meatballs late at night, correct?
Yeah,
and so here we go. New book comes out today, and you guys can buy that. There are 36 different recipes for meatballs, and we are going to teach you some of the classics right now. Really, the classic is the one we're starting with. The classic.
Classic beef meatball.
Delicious meatball.
Classic beef.
Doesn't get better than this.
More popular ball at the shop.
We have the best thing about all of these meatballs in our cookbook is they're really simple. So everything is just mix it all up, roast them off. We have ricotta cheese. You want to just throw it all in there?
Yeah.
Ricotta cheese, eggs, a little bit of ground fennel seeds, some chili flakes.
What makes this the classic? Why is this the most popular at your location?
I think it's the beef. I think people are not.
Is all of this
Parmesan cheese right in
there?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're not afraid.
Are you scared?
I'm
throwing this in there.
All right.
Parsley.
All right.
A little oregano, fresh oregano.
And you do the big leaf?
Oh, yeah, big leaf. We are very rustic.
It's honestly, it's like a full course dinner.
This is all your five food groups wrapped into a meatball.
Into a beautiful little package.
Mix it all up, and these are probably the best invention for making a meatball ever created.
Little mini ice cream scoopers.
Mini meatballs.
Save you the time. Just pop them right in the pan and straight in the oven.
Are you a fan of the giant meatball or the mini meatball?
I love a big ball, but you know, I take after my grandmother. My grandmother was a huge fan of tiny balls.
I didn't say it. Let it be on record.
Right. Right in the oven, and because they're small, you don't have to wait forever. About 17 minutes, and we like to braise our balls as well. A little bit of tomato sauce, which recipe is obviously also in the book.
In the new book out today.
Did you tasted these meatballs?
May
earlier?
I? Yes, yeah. I wouldn't mind another one. I know you guys have many recipes. In the meantime,
awesome.
George is here. He's already
chilling. George, let me talk to you really quickly about these guys. These are the spicy pork meatballs. We serve them classically with the spicy meat sauce. Little kick, little punch. They're really, really delicious. Simply at the shop.
Pork shoulder, right?
Pork shoulder. We roast them just like we do with the rest of the meatballs. This is the spicy meat sauce. It's done with pork as well.
Do you guys want
some? We just ladle these guys right on top here. At the shop, typically we grade some cheese over the top.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're afraid of cheese,
just
let us know.
And what's your big spice here?
This is our basil.
That's oregano, but it's actually for the croutons because we're going to be making gobble gobble balls, our Thanksgiving special.
All right. Those gobble gobble balls are coming up next. This is the real simple way to do this. So finish up here with the spicy pork.
Did you like those
sauce?
Meatballs?
I love them. I'm going to put some more sauce on.
Yeah, man.
Delicious.
You got to put some more sauce on.
Meantime, you have a special meatball you're going to show Robin or Sam how to make.
We were going to be making these gobble gobble balls. How are you?
I'm well, man. How are you?
Are you a fan of Thanksgiving?
I love Thanksgiving.
Have you ever had Thanksgiving in ball form?
No, I have not.
If you don't have time to roast a turkey and make cranberry sauce and make the stuffing, we have a meatball that encompasses all
those
flavors.
I love that idea. And how do you do that?
We basically take turkey and stuffing and cranberries and we grind them all up and we roast them together and they're super delicious. We have some croutons that we put in so that you get the stuffing inside. Just some garlic and some oregano and olive oil. It's super tasty.
And this is the end result?
And these are the end result. And I had some yesterday and I was impressed.
Really?
I was impressed. That's the great thing about a mini ball. You pop the whole thing in your mouth. And if she was not eating, she would say they are.
It's Thanksgiving in my mouth.
That is Thanksgiving. She is giving thanks for Thanksgiving in her mouth.
These are the veggie meatballs. We do a classic pesto at the meatball shop. That is my favorite pairing with the veggie meatball.
I read that, and when I saw this, I thought, I'm not going to like this. Who wants a veggie meatball?
Have you tried it?
Yes, I tried it, and I loved it.
It's hearty.
It is
delicious.
Not kidding.
14 ingredients. What we do here with the pesto, little walnuts, little spinach, some basil, some Parmesan cheese, little oil.
It is so good.
The great thing about this pesto, without any raw garlic in there, you could use it as a dipping sauce. You don't have to worry about your guests.
This is definitely by far my favorite pairing at the shop.
It's good, but I got to tell you, that's great too.
Are those
and you got a tough crowd. Look at this one now.
Oh.
This
is Eliza.
Eliza's got two little meatballs in her cheeks. Right
and
now.
We have this is great for the tailgate, and this is great for the big game. This is a buffalo chicken wing meatballs.
Is all the flavors of a buffalo chicken wing without the bones, and we put them on the menu for one Super Bowl, and they were so popular that people are screaming for them every day.
Oh, sure.
This is the buffalo chicken wing, no bone, no mess.
All right, here we go.
Pop them in your mouth.
Are you going to go for
really,
it?
Really,
Eliza,
great.
They might be a little spicy for
maybe a little much.
You never know.
Eliza, you are.
She looks like you have beautiful eyes.
Can I taste that really quickly?
Please do.
Yeah, absolutely.
The buffalo chicken wing meatball is a fan favorite.
Oh, that is so
really. Is that your favorite?
Right? Really good.
You can't go wrong.
No, what do you think of when you see Josh? What movie? The Hangover, right?
Oh my God, I know.
You are incredible.
You just have the tattoo.
You guys, the name of the book, The Meatball Shop Cookbook. Thank you guys so much. What do you want to say?
Meatball Shop Cookbook. If you don't have time to come down to New York, make them yourself.
It is easy to do. These guys are wonderful, and the meatballs, not too shabby. Thank you so much. Check
thank
out more
you,
info on goodmorningamerica.com, on Yahoo, and we will be
you
right back.
You bet, Eliza. You
awesome.
Bet.
You're awesome.